You just couldn't stay away, huh? Your personality is that addictive that you could not step out from these spotlights, even though you said you were gonna leave. Is everybody happy to see the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels? You happy? I tell you what is gonna make me happy is in a couple weeks, I don't know if you know this, July 17th, I'm leaving. That's my last day.
I'll cheer for that myself.
So what you're saying is that none of these people are gonna have to hear or see from you again? That sounds like a win-win.
It is a win-win, because clearly it's what they want, it's what I want. Win. 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 Well, you know, win, not only is a hotel on the strip, win is what you didn't do when you left the WWE. You lost! Hey, everybody, I'm gonna beat The Undertaker. You didn't beat The Undertaker, you went out a loser, unlike me, who's gonna go out a winner. And not only am I going out a winner, I'm going to leave your WWE champion.
Have you run all this by John Cena? Because isn't he the WWE champion? I'm sure he's going to have a problem with this.
John Cena is the WWE champion. John Cena is also the person I beat live here on Raw 2 weeks ago. So I have no doubt, Money in the Bank pay-per-view in Chicago, Illinois, I am leaving with John Cena's WWE Championship. And one of the reasons I'm leaving is all of you. It really is sad that you would rather put your hands together and get on your feet for a Hall of Famer, the past Shawn Michaels, than get on your hands and knees and beg the future to stay.
At the end of the day, just so you know, the reason they cheer me is because they know that I'm better than you.
I'm not gonna lie, Shawn, you were better than me. See, the thing is, there's nobody back there right now that can hold a candle to me, just like when you were here, there was nobody in the back that could hold a candle to you. So you saying that you're better than me now, I don't know, that kind of sounds like a, is that a challenge? Is that what that is? Is that a challenge? Because I know you used to be this brash, rebellious superstar. You know, me and you, we're a lot alike in that regard. I'll say whatever I want.
I got news for you. You and I are not alike. Certainly we've got similarities. We don't smoke, we don't drink, we don't do drugs, but you know
anymore.
Something? Fair enough. But you know what? At the end of the day, a guy like you, you've got your style, and I've got mine.
Oh! Sweet chin music! Tonga! Woohoo! Man!
You just made the biggest mistake of your life.
Attention, please. I've just received an email from the anonymous Raw general manager. And I quote, Punk, you leaving WWE is your decision. But seeing that you only have 3 Monday Night Raws left,
We're going to make them count. Since you're already in the ring, you're going to have the first match tonight on Raw Roulette. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's spin the wheel.
Hi, this is Booker T, master of the spinneroony. Just want to show you some of the matches we have in store tonight for Raw Roulette. The on a pole match. Special guest referees match. Submission match. Steel cage. My favorite, the pillow fight match. Now, CM Punk, I'm going to spin this thing up to find out exactly what kind of match you're going to compete in tonight.
Can you imagine CM Punk in a pillow fight match? Who would his opponent be?
Let's see exactly what you win. Question mark. I know you're wondering what that means. CM Punk, this means you have a mystery opponent. This also means you, CM Punk, have won an all-expense-paid trip to hell. Because you're going to face this man, Kane.
Sweet chin music to the McGillicuddy.
Good luck with all that.